Hey there guys, it's your favorite backyard geographer out in the field here at Panum Crater, just a little bit south of Mono Lake here in California. I'm here to explore the crater itself, talk about the geology, and really to observe this really unique plug dome volcano system that's full of obsidian and pumice. So let's go. So our volcanism story really begins here, just over 40,000 years ago. Behind me you can see part of the Mono Craters. Those are some of the earlier craters that we can observe in this area, but I'm standing here again in Panum Crater, which is really unique. It's a plug dome. So behind me you can see that there's the rim. So the way that this volcanism works is that you had this material underneath the surface, and there was water as well at the top. So as that molten material was being forced to cool down, it immediately created steam. And at some point, it built up enough, about 700 years ago, that it exploded. And in that explosion, created this massive crater that we see around us. In that explosion, you then are left with the rim that is mostly made out of pumice and other lake debris, lacustrine material that's been deposited. But then what's neat about it is that after that happened, we have the plug dome in the middle. And the plug dome, kind of like toothpaste, was really viscous, very sticky. And as it was squeezing out kind of slowly, it began to crystallize, creating this really unique feature in the center of this volcano. Okay, now we're inside the plug dome itself, and since geology rocks, let's talk a little bit about what we stand facing. So I'm holding a piece of obsidian here, which is predominantly what we see within this plug dome itself. And what we have in front of me here is a large piece of pumice. Both are silica rich, but they have different cooling processes. So the pumice itself is vesicular. It has a lot of air bubbles that were trapped in it when it was cooling rapidly, when the explosion originally occurred about 700 years ago. Because of the porosity that this rock has, all these air vesicles, it will actually float on water, which is pretty cool. Now going back to this piece of obsidian though, a little bit different of a history in the sense that on this side of the Eastern Sierra, the Mono Basin itself, there's a lot of obsidian up here, which is volcanic glass. But the early indigenous people used this to create their arrowheads. And we find remnants of this all over the state. And it's because the people on this side of the Sierra would trade it, and they'd trade the obsidian to other tribes. So this side of the eastern side of the Sierra was known for their obsidian and their baskets. But on the western side of the Sierra, they're known for their beadwork and baskets as well, but different types of baskets though. But it's just really neat when you start to find these pieces of history that date back thousands of years culturally, where it comes back geologically here at Panum Crater. Look at this perfect piece of pumice. This is a little bit larger than a softball. Probably weighs 6 ounces, and you know what it's really good for? Scraping that stuff off the bottom of your heels, those calluses. Oh, and toilets too. I'll act it out for you. The best part about walking these trails is that you get exposed to all kinds of unique vegetation, and my favorite here, the rabbit brush, because we're here in late fall when it's blooming, and I'm incredibly allergic to it. Hey! Check this out. This is a prime example of flow banding. Obsidian, volcanic glass, silica rich. But look, because it cooled so rapidly, it shattered in its cooling process. Huh. Thanks for joining me on our adventure here at Panum Crater in Mono County. We're here at one of the highest points along that rim. Great spot to end because we can see beautiful Mono Lake behind us. Don't forget to click like, subscribe, and we'll talk soon. Again at Panum Crater.